The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
People were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced the children and blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Welcome po sa Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. Somebody asks a wise man these questions. How much does the grace of God matter if one is to be successful? Ulitin ko po yung tanong. How much does the grace of God matter if one is to be successful? The wise man answered, 100%. Then he asked again, then how much does self-effort work if one is to be successful? Then the wise man answered again, 100%. Mga kapatid, this proverb best explain the intention of our Lord in our gospel today. Because if we look into it, when Jesus rebuked his disciples for not letting the children approach him and said that the kingdom of God is to these little ones, he was not telling us that dependence on God would mean that we would do nothing, na wala tayong gagawin. Na kapag tayo nagtitiwala sa Diyos, wala tayong gagawin. But instead, when he said to be like the little ones, our Lord is telling us that we have to grow in our choices. Kailangan natin lumago sa lahat ng desisyon na gagawin natin sa ating buhay. Because it is only through our decisions that we can grow in our faith too. That we can mature in our faith too. Paano, mga kapatid? You see, sometimes there are choices, there are decisions that we got it right. But sometimes we got it wrong. There are choices that is easy for us to make. But there are also choices that are difficult to do. There are choices, you know, that sometimes we are pleased when we do it. Now we are happy na ginawa ko tong desisyon na ito. But there are also choices that we regret from doing it. And then it is through these choices that we realize, no, that our Lord is helping us. Actually po yung proverb na yun kaninang sinabi ko kanina, hindi po nagtapos doon. Meron siyang sinabi a little sentence afterwards. Ang sabi niya ganito, "Only when we give our best effort that we will realize that there's an unseen hand helping us." Kapag daw ginawa natin yung best effort natin, dun lang daw natin makikita na may tumutulong sa atin. And I think that is what our gospel is inviting us today. Because dependence of God is not about, again, I will repeat, is not about the lack of action on our part. Na wala tayong gagawin, aasa natin lahat sa Diyos. We let God make the decisions for us. Hindi po eh. But dependence on God is about having the humility to receive help. Na aminin natin na kailangan natin ng tulong. Dependence of God would also mean to us having the humility to fail and learn from our mistakes. Dependence of God would actually mean having the humility to receive guidance. Because at the end of the day, that is what dependence of God means for us. You know, mga kapatid, yes, when we make decisions in our life, we have to pray for it, definitely. Sapagkat kailangan natin ang tulong ng Diyos for us to be guided in our decisions. But we will also realize that is only after we have made the decisions that we will receive the help from God. Pagkatapos lamang na kapag tayo nakagawa na ng desisyon, doon lang natin mararanasan kung anong ibig sabihin ng grasya ng Diyos. Pero kailangan natin gumawa ng desisyon. Kaya nga siguro mga kapatid, as we continue our celebration, we ask for God's help. Alam ko may mga desisyon na po tayo nagawa sa buhay natin. May mga bagay na tayong napag-decidean kung anong gagawin natin sa buhay natin. Pero siguro po, ang pinakamahalaga is that we have to realize that we are much open to God's grace while we are accomplishing these decisions in our life. We have the humility to receive help, as I've said. Kaya nating humingi ng tulong. And I think, kung babalikan po natin yung unang pagbasa, the first reading, yun po yung sinasabi ng letter to St. James. Kaya nga po sinasabi rin ng letter to St. James, faith without work is nothing. Sapagkat kailangan natin na gumawa. Sapagkat doon sa gawa, doon tayo tinutulungan ng Diyos. Kaya nga siguro mga kapatid, as an invitation, no? As we continue our celebration, we continue to ask God's grace in our life. But we have to do our best effort too. You know, sometimes people say that they were forced to do some choices in life. Their situation forced them to do a certain choice in their life. Parang sinasabing wala akong say doon sa ginawa kong desisyon sa buhay ko. But in reality, mga kapatid, every decision that was made in our life, we have a say. Meron tayong sabi. Kaya nga, we cannot blame others for having decided on something. Kahit sabihin natin na pinilit lang po ako ng parents ko na maging doktor or maging teacher or maging engineer, hindi pwede natin pong sabihin iyon. O maging pare in that case. Sapagkat once we have decided also to receive that decision of our parents, tayo na rin mismo ang magsasabi kung paano natin to i-accomplish. Kaya nga po, napakalaki ng bagay ng paggagawa ng desisyon sa buhay ng isang Kristiyano. And our Lord is asking us today to have the heart of a child when we make decisions in our life so that we can always have the humility and not to be arrogant in our life when our Lord is willing to help us. May awa ang Diyos. May awa ang Diyos. May awa ang Diyos. Pero ang tao ay dapat gawin din ang kanyang dapat gawin. Amen.